Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today I want to talk about ductwork and the noise transmission that goes on in our ductwork in our HVAC systems. Hot air, cool air, depending on what climate and region of the country that you work in. So ductwork sometimes looks like this in square rectangular tubes and stuff like that goes through our house. And then, so we have the air movement through the ductwork, and that air movement, you know, obviously excites the air inside the ductwork. And since it's a small space, we all know about small room acoustics, and it's a constant battle with reflections off these surfaces. So it's the air inside that gets moving and creates the noise. So depending on the length, depending on the width, depending on the volume of the ductwork, you're going to have certain noise, certain frequencies contributing in that noise at certain amplitudes. So how do we work with the air movement and the structural vibrations? Because usually this ductwork is attached to, you know, a compressor that has a fan, and all of that, you know, gets all of this moving and everything else, and then the air inside of the ductwork gets moving. So you have to allow and plan for both of those noise issues. Most of the noise that's airborne exits through the vent. And about the last 3 feet of every vent is the most noisiest. So you have to allow for that in your planning. So structurally, how do we do that? Well, we work structurally with supports around the ductwork. And, you know, you can brace the ductwork and minimize the movement of the ductwork. And then you can line the inside of the ductwork with different materials. Now, you have to be very, very careful here. Lining the ductwork with materials that can break off and be suspended in the air and pushed through the ductwork into the environment, you have to be careful. Spoke with a gentleman the other day who lined all his ductworks with fiberglass. Well, fiberglass is very harmful. We've done a video in our shop, and we'll be releasing it shortly, that shows those particles. We put a piece of it on our table and we dropped a hammer on it, and then we filmed all the particles coming up from it. And they're light and they're suspended in air. So you have to be very careful about what kind of material that you put for the lining. If you're not concerned with the structural vibration, you're only concerned with the noise out of the vent here, then you want to treat the 3 foot area from the vent into the ductwork and let the rest of the ductwork go. What's some good materials to use? Open cell foams. They don't shed. They don't do anything that will hurt you. Building insulation, fiberglass, all those particles come off, get into the air, get into your lungs, and then, you know, you'll have all kinds of issues. If you have a lot of vibration, structural modifications, we can float the cooler and the fan on isolation feet. We can put isolation technology between the cooler and the fan and the ductwork itself. So there's all kinds of things that you can do, but be very, very careful about what you line the inside of the ductwork with. And then just use this first 3 foot as your kind of your guideline when you're doing treatment. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today. And if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.